Welcome to the Hutchinson's Interactive Encyclopedia. You are now looking at the menu screen. The objects displayed are your means of exploring the content of the encyclopedia. By moving your cursor over these, you will reveal the many ways of navigating through the vast amount of multimedia content on this disk. We will now take you on a short tour of these powerful functions. You can, of course, leave this tour at any time by clicking on the audio off button at the bottom of your screen. At the top left is the desk lamp. Clicking on this icon whenever it appears will automatically bring you back to this home menu screen. Now move your cursor to the hourglass and click to access the timeline. Timeline allows you to look at a specific time in world history, from 4 million BC to the present day. History is divided into distinct periods, and within each period, you can investigate events and personalities further. The unique On This Day feature lists key historical anniversaries and events for every day of the year. Welcome back to the menu screen. Now move your cursor to the cubes and click to access Topics. Topics allows you to investigate the encyclopedia's content on a thematic basis. There are over 90 themes for you to explore. Now move your cursor to the globe and click to access the Atlas. The Atlas gives you access to the world on global, continental, and national levels. Clicking on the question mark allows you to test your general knowledge in an exciting quiz format. Quiz includes thousands of questions with answers sourced from the content of the encyclopedia. You can adjust the level of difficulty of the questions. You can also set yourself a challenge by setting a time limit for the answers. Quiz provides hours of fun. To help you improve your quiz rating, the Browse function is invaluable. Access this now by moving your cursor under the lamp and clicking on the Open Book. Browse allows you to explore the encyclopedia at random. You can limit your browse to specific subjects if you wish. By clicking on the magnifying glass, you access the powerful Search facility. Search gives you the opportunity to type in your inquiry. You can type in a single word or a sequence of words defining your search parameters more closely. By clicking on the card index, you can access the entire content of the encyclopedia. Index is an alphabetical listing of the entire contents of the encyclopedia. Icons indicate the nature of the multimedia content. Video, sound, photographs, as well as text, can be accessed from this index. The final location on our tour is Display, accessed via the book icon in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Click on it. Display has two main functions. By clicking on a word, you can access directly an article on that subject. Alternatively, the navigation screen allows you to select topics on a given subject area and to store the selection for future reference. The icons we have just explored appear on all the screens of the encyclopedia. Clicking on one of these icons gives you direct access to that function without going via the home screen. In addition, each function screen has a sound help icon. Clicking on this will give you a voice guide to the functions on that screen. You now have the information necessary to explore the full potential of the Hutchinson's Interactive Encyclopedia. We hope you'll have many hours of informative enjoyment from this disc. Timeline allows you to access the historical information. Display allows you to investigate the content of the encyclopedia in detail.
Pounding such as the world had never known. Nazi bombs could raise her buildings, but nothing could trample her spirit. The spirit perfectly exemplified by Prime Minister Churchill. All during London's great trial, he was constantly on the scene, encouraging the living, honoring the dead.
rather like sending your opening batsman to the crease, only for them to find, the moment the first balls are bowled, that their bats have been broken before the game by the team captain.
This is London. A quarter of an hour ago, the Prime Minister came to the bar of the House and handed to the Speaker a message from His Majesty the King. Here is the text of the message, which was read by the Speaker. After long and anxious consideration...
Yesterday, we broadcast a reminder on the proper way to take care of the gas masks that have been distributed, and a warning against such strange misuses as testing the masks in gas ovens and by the exhaust pipes of motor cars.
Friends and comrades, the light has gone out of our lives, and there is darkness everywhere, and I do not quite know what to tell you.
And the Mach meter now reads 0.92. And the Mach meter now reads 0.92, just below the speed of sound, and we can distinctly feel, as the reheat comes on, the aircraft accelerating and climbing very slightly. Mach meter now reads 0.94. Bump as the reheat comes on, and the Mach meter is now climbing 0.96, 0.97, 0.99, and there it is. We're now flying through the sound barrier.
Gentlemen, Captain, we are now supersonic.
Mr. President, you deserve great credit for your part in these transforming events. I salute you as well for the process of change you brought to your own country.
The prohibition of the African National Congress, the Pan-Africanist Congress, the South African Communist Party, and a number of subsidiary organizations is being rescinded.
To you all, and not least to those who organized this tribute, I offer my warmest gratitude
It's a totally different South Africa. And along the route, I was surprised to see the number of whites who seem to identify themselves with what is happening in the country today amongst blacks.
If you are to see and go to the countryside, we have enough food. We have a lot of medicine in hospitals. We have increased the salary of the people of Uganda. Even the former regime never increased the salary of the people, but we have increased the salary of the people. And we are growing more crops for export that we are getting foreign exchange. If you are to see and go, and we have bought cash, such an airplane like a Boeing L-100 from United States, and we are buying still more.
In South Africa, native protest flared. South Africa, native protest flared against apartheid and passport laws. 100 died when police fired on demonstrators at Sharpeville. Then came the attempted assassination of Premier Firavut by a white farmer. Firavut survived and apartheid continued. But throughout 1960, all Africa was in ferment.
Years ago, a vast cloud of gas and dust floated through the galaxy we call the Milky Way, the ghostly remains of a great star that had died in a gigantic explosion. The gas and dust is twisted and shaped by magnetic forces, electrical currents, and the subtle pull of gravity. As it swirls around a thickening core, the huge cloud gradually flattens into a disk. Dust and gas gravitate slowly inwards, and eddies begin to form in the cloud. Particles of matter cluster.
France's North African colonial empire was dealt a crippling blow during the year as revolt raged throughout Morocco, Algeria, and Tunisia. So severe were the uprisings, which cost the lives of thousands, that France was forced to restore the once exiled Sultan, Mohammed Ben Youssef, who returned in triumph to his capital city of Rabat. The nationalist leader, who had spent 18 months on the island of Madagascar, returned to power, and his resumption of the throne proved a rallying point for Arab feeling throughout North Africa. Became another world trouble spot. The Near East became another world trouble spot with the nationalization and seizure of the world's largest oil refinery in Abadan in Iran. A fifth of the world's oil supply was cut off, and nationalist feeling ran high against Britain and the Western democracies. Attempts to arbitrate the differences made by America's Avril Harriman failed to solve the Anglo-Iranian dispute. Egypt also was caught up in the conflict with a demand of Britain's ouster from the Suez and Sudan. Premier Mossadegh, spearhead of the oil nationalization program, took his case to the United Nations, where he remained adamant in his stand and raised the specter of possible Russian intervention and acquisition of the huge oil reserves. It was but one of the difficult questions that faced the United Nations in a year of stalemate between the free nations and those of the Iron Curtain.
I, Nelson Rodriguez Mandela, do hereby swear to be faithful to the Republic of South Africa.
Will you please raise your right hand and say, so help me God.
So help me God.
After decades of dreaming and planning, the St. Lawrence Seaway became a reality. In gala ceremonies, Queen Elizabeth and President Eisenhower officially opened the 2,400-mile link between deep water and the heart of the continent. Beatles. This rock and roll group has taken over as the kingpins of musical appreciation among the younger element. Some music critics call their harmony unmistakably diatonic. Others say it's pandiatomic. Parents say it's just plain pandemonium. Their first meeting with the American press brings forth an interview laced with quips and humor. You'd laugh, too, with a gross of $17 million last year. New York City cops are hard-pressed protecting the Beatles at their hotel. On every side, there is hero worship that recalls the heydays of Elvis Presley and Frank Sinatra. With one Beatle bedded with a sore throat, three of the quartet taken airing in Central Park, there was absolutely no truth to the rumor that the zoo's laughing hyena was driven underground.
Gully Aylmum Jefferson Clinton.
Lord Jenkins, the Chancellor of the University, greeted the President in Latin before he awarded the degree. When he replied, President Clinton used English.
I thought if there was one place in the world I could come and give a speech in the proper language, it was here, and then I heard the degree ceremony. And sure enough, once again at Oxford, I was another Yank half step behind.
The lava is on the move. In the hills just above the town of Zafarana, it is flowing down with what looks like renewed intensity. Earlier today, the authorities had claimed partial success. They said they'd slowed it down, but the success was temporary. The threat is back. This man told us, you never know what the mountain is going to do. It plays ugly tricks. Only Jesus Christ knows what will happen.